I just don't think they expected the aggro try coming out of EG. They put a sentry, but it's in the off lane, blocking the large camp. So we'll see if SG can get a good try lane going here on the bright. Oh, look at that heal bomb.
You might want to worry about top lane as well. Here comes just Spin. Oh, GRD, they're going to get the kill. Zayat's going to fall. Arteezy, he doesn't do anywhere near enough damage. It was the battery assault the clockwork started with. Now Crit thinks about the stunner. She lets it go over on the warlock. I'm assuming not many kills on bottom lane, considering you could press the attack off the sticky napalm.
Yeah, it's a very good matchup for EG. Part of the reason they aggroed here.
Yeah. Let's Universe have the good times then. Frickin' taunt Crit, as well as GRD. They battle for the rune. It was actually taken by the clockwork. Support's coming in. It's coming in from Cat with the battery assault damage. Is this Sadik going to actually have a bit of a say? It does. He actually lets the Hadouken out. And maybe now it's clockwork. The cogs, it pushes Zai away. Clockwork lives on 37. Cat on 152.
To execute Legion's full beat. If he just battery, or if he just Dream Coil's the right heroes, maybe the Warlock, the Clockwork can make it.
They're going again top lane, just walking through the tree lines. GRD being so patient about this. Juggernaut's got the spin available back under the tower with a Shadow Word, the damage. Zai, he's still got a Shadow Wave up his sleeve. Drops low, but will it be low enough with a Shadow Word? 54, 35, 17,
oh,
0! The last tick will do the job.
That was
Observer Ward behind the tower. So they understand that Zai is all alone.
They did.
You don't have special haunt yet. Like, okay, you put Arteezy on bottom lane, and I try and reach his level 6, but SG, they force the issue. Universe comes in, duel is available, Juggernaut. No Omni Slash is up, so what do you do? You duel the Juggernaut, you bring him down. Some mail rotates in the perfect time, gets a Dream Call stun.
No
Batrider will fall to Zai. He lives, the Shadow Word is ticking him down. He understands he'll fall, but before he does, he gets the last hit in on Cat, the sole survivor of that catastrophe on the top lane.
But Arteezy is by far the better one. And by spotting Zai, they know where the grave is.
Well, Arteezy's going to play aggressive. He's walking up the lane. Now, Firefly, you probably assume is down, but now with the Firefly Vision, the jump in, they got Laguna Blade if they want to commit it. It's not even necessary. Arteezy down way too far, and he'll end up getting picked off.
Really well done. The best part is the bounce there, so even if he tries to dagger into trees, they can still chase.
Spin bottom lane, they're trying to find the opening with impressed attack. It's time to duel! And Legion Commander plus 20.
Universe is just really having amazing Legion Commander performances every time.
Defensive. He's just walking through the tree line away from his tower. Obviously, he's got spin to protect him, but with no one defending this tier 1 tower on bottom lane, warning bells must start ringing. And here's Universe. Blink in, duel, and now welcome to plus 40 on a Legion Commander 13 minutes in.
Pretty large amount of damage, and I think the goal is if he gets stunned, that even if Lina reflects spells on him, that
ADR,
she'll possibly kill herself.
Be careful, he's underneath the sentry ward. Universe, he actually has Blink Duel available, so they go for the quick silence. Dream Coil as well. Already, you bring down one. Spectral Haunt forcing SG to start the retreat. They're back onto their side of the river, apart from Clockwork, who's dueled up. Plus 50 now on Legion Commander. The DPS just keeps rolling in after successful gank after successful gank. It's the Observer Ward. Again, EG have this great vision that just sees everything SG is doing.
They know right when they're about to retreat. They won't see the TP in hero, so maybe they're a little more hesitant to actually dive. No, Smell goes in.
Yeah, they saw him on bottom lane farming up, so Smell just goes to the Dream Call, trying to buy time for the rest of EG to arrive, and there it is. Press the attack, and then it's time to duel. The Rock will fall, Fatal Bonds will connect them up together, but they still need to do damage to make these Fatal Bonds work, and maybe there is a chance. Universe, Shallow Grave will keep him alive. They still need another burst heal, and Universe has got to press the attack, comes off cooldown right now. He can't get it off in the nick of time, will it? No, Smell, he'll orb out. They're losing too many again. SG, Smell is off position, puts him in the great position to kill off Cat as he runs away. The Rock look good. SG just got caught without their Juggernaut and they'll lose everything that was left behind. Racking up these charges. Universe is moving up. Maybe if they can isolate him, the Observer and Sentry's in a good position. But the Sentry Ward scouting out Crit. The Smoke Ward breaks. They didn't actually have the Observer Ward up on the hillside. That actually belongs to Crit. But Blink, Lasso, Shallow Grave very early over on the park. The Rock will drop, trying to keep them out of this engagement. The Samael straight back into the middle. The Taunt is actually on the clockwork. He can't run away from the duel, not to mention the double stun. It was Cat and ADR unable to get the distance. Now Juggernaut, Omni Slash needs to do a lot of work here. But will it be enough? Triggers the Mana Style, looking for a kill. Mill and Universe. That'll be huge if they can claim, but Universe, the damage output is ridiculously high. He'll lose his life, but he does the job. That's easy. He moves back. He's low on life, but it's ADR versus Samael. This Lina needs more time, needs more life, has to deny himself with the Bloodstone. No other choice. SG will lose everything.
Control the map, and we have a dead Grim Protector for 6 seconds. Also, yep. Overgrowth was used, so.
But SG's now going to fight without Hookshot and without Lasso. So they're pushing into the Tier 1 tower, and this is against everything EG's got apart from Overgrowth. And you know Universe wants it. There's your duel. He goes on the target. It's Alina. The Rock. Can it buy enough space with a Fatal Bond? Probably not enough. Universe is low, but the Shallow Grave, he wants a TP out. He'll actually be cancelled. So Universe will fall. They lost Alina, but she'll be back up in just a second. Not to mention the spin. That's easy. Huge kill. Coming in again. More money rolling into the Juggernaut. He will be silenced up. The Aegis Immortal is up the sleeve. So remember, if he can commit EG into a fight that they can take. Lina will TP out to that shrine in just a second. So if Samael jumps forward, you know he's in deep. He's still chasing the Juggernaut, but Hookshot will cancel his movement. Slow on the clockwork, down to 22 life, but then the lasso up at the perfect time, but so is the Shallow Grave. Samael, he'll burn the Aegis Immortal, but loses his life for it? No, he actually will TP away the cover of living armor. Samael will survive.
They scan it.
He's on top of the Obs ward. So here comes the movement. Smoke up from SG. Yep, they're looking to counter-initiate. Careful with the Light Striker raise. Yeah. Don't do it on top of the Obs ward. He still wants to keep the buff ups. Here comes the Legion Commander and the jump forward. The duel is out. The clockwork almost gone, but the rock will drop. Not to mention the Fatal Bonds. Universe taking so much damage, but he's still alive. Finally, he is brought down. But the damage, it may be enough. Cat's out of here. Or will he? He's shadow wording up, but Samael, yeah, he's the one with the Obs. RTZ through the tree lines. They had enough damage, enough positioning over SG that there's just no way to run away. Crit.
Basically, if they lose the team fight here, EG does have to go far to take billions on the enemy side.
Yep.
It'll be alright.
Top lane's actually pushing in quite nicely when you leave a spec illusion up there. Pushing in with Radiance, but bottom lane, here they come. Juggernaut, Aegis Immortal to protect him. There goes your duel with a Blade Mail up. Juggernaut, he's still alive for the moment. The Weave is good. How much damage have they got? Legion is dropping. The Shallow Grave is going to wear off in just a second. Not to mention, they're all fatally bonded together. Plus the upheaval. EG can't move properly. Not easy. Caught outside. The damage he's taking is actually killing off the rest of his team at the moment. The Fatal Bonds, he's done so much work. Now the Omni Slash with the Lasso. EG, they don't have the control. SG, they are trying to make EG America their home. If it's going to be possible, the Tier 3 Tower will fall. They stick around. They're looking for the melee racks, but backdoor protection is actually helping EG, but Samael gets bashed! The Juggernaut, he got the hit, but where is the puck? Can they find him? Universe back in again. No duel. They actually waited out. Universe, he's gonna fall. They've lost too many.
No way.
Mass buyback. SG, Brazil is pushing through, but will it be enough? Puck wants to come back in. Nope, the melee racks is falling. All they can do right now, EG, is dissuade SG from going for more than. Can they do that?
If they get one more pick, it changes everything. That's two buybacks off of EG. Puck got killed just barely from the flame break, even after the blink comes through. And if they can get Arteezy, he's got a ton of HP. Oh, he's gonna go for the kill.
The damage is enough. The Gem of True Sight dropped from the Warlock. But look at Lina. He wants to get in there. They want more. They're looking at the melee racks. There's still a couple of seconds before you got more reinforcements. They'll burn the fortification.
Careful.
Dream Coil is out. Juggernaut can't get out of this one. Oh, can he? He bashes Samael. They Laguna Blade. Samael. He's still alive, however. Phase shift just too good. Tavo on the run. Up the trees. Far, far away to the land of Oz, the place of happy dreams, where you, Brazil, could potentially bring down EG. Tavo, he's got both gems, one for each eye, and the Dagon plumbs him right between him on the nose.
And I'm just looking at the EG items, and I feel like they needed some BKBs, maybe.
They're coming.
I don't know.
EG is coming. They smoke up. SG will go inside the pit. They're looking at Roshan. Samael! The five-man coil! With the cogs will lock him in, but the duel doesn't work! SG, they've lost three! This could be a disaster in the pit! They've lost four! Make it a wipe! Is it possible? Juggernaut comes out, the Omni Slash. He will go down. Lina's coming back to help out, but now she reveals her position. She bought back to be involved in this. EG, they got the winning moment. The fight on Roshan, and they're back in this.
RTZ instantly uses Manta, sends the illusions to the background, and does pick off the healing ward. No shrine used just yet. Shadow Ward can buy them some time, but the tower is getting low.
Here goes out to Easy. Jump forward. Where's that control? He might have it. The lasso pulls him in. The rock and fatal bonds. It connects him up. The cogs making it difficult for EG to move, but they've already killed off the Batrider. Clockwork will join him as well. Back towards the shrine. Lina, the double stun into an Omni Slash. Crit will fall. Arteezy's copying a lot more of the damage. A straight out bash as well from the Juggernaut. Arteezy, remember, you've got two of him and they have to bring him down. Arteezy is currently just burning the kills out, killing off Cat with just the Radiance, but the damage is there. ADR able to do the work. Aegis Immortal, welcome to the respawn back up again. A quick line strike array gonna miss his target as Arteezy as well as Universe. Now they focus on the melee ranks with no buybacks for both the Warlock as well as the Batrider. Critical things missing here from the SG team fight. They need something more. Diffuser Blade Charge goes on Arteezy. The Hawkshot down to the side. Maybe that's a good isolation over on Universe, but the duel will begin. He was protected by the Shallow Grave, so a winner is back again, but Universe pumped down by ADR. Took so much damage, had to play around the shrine. It's not enough for him either. Down for 72 seconds. It's all up to the Juggernaut. He needs to repel the American Solo into the spin. Needs the damage. Samael is low, but he's not going to drop. They're all dead, but then the buyback. SG, the Breath of Life. Can they hold the ground with just the Juggernaut? Do they let this tower go? SG, they need to delay longer. 26 seconds till Lina is up. Batrider, you can see him preparing. He is pouncing or waiting to. The upheaval slowing down Arteezy. The melee rax is gone. Range rax will join them. And maybe, where's the opportunity? The bash is out. Arteezy has no mana. He has no protection. Tarvo, this Firefly will wear off in a second. He just needs to lasso with an extra bash from the Juggernaut. Now they turn. The Dream Call is up. Warlock, still no rock. Has to commit the defensive Shadow Web. No, the duel is out from Universe. They bring him down. He is down for 2 minutes. No buyback available for the Juggernaut. But Lina is up and running. A fresh Bloodthorn has now been purchased. It must stay alive.
He's actually really low on mana though. If they go and Zai right now and they mana burn him just a little bit, they could possibly get a kill without duel.
Arteezy's on the front line. They have to do something now. They have to do something.
It's now
Tier
or never.
4 towers are down. The Ancient is opened up. Where is the opening? It's the lasso. They find the Legion Commander. The damage, the Battle Bonds, the Rock will connect. SG, they find the damage, but Universe still alive. He's going to bring him down. The Clockwork will fall. The Shadow Grave did the work. Even though Universe is on the sideline for 105 seconds, the Ancient's still open. Arteezy, he's hitting into it. He's looking for the kill.